Hello everyone. In this video, we will explore latches, a key component of sequential digital circuits used to store data. We will cover what latches are and their functionality, the two types of latches, positive and negative level sensitive latches, and the importance of timing arc, setup time, and hold time in ensuring proper operation. A latch is a sequential digital circuit that can store a single bit value. It has two inputs, data and enable, and one output, signal Q. A latch samples the input data and it can store or hold the input value depending on the state of the enable signal. Here is the interface block diagram of a latch. D represents the data input, EN is the enable input, and Q is the output signal. The enable signal EN is usually clock signal in sequential latch circuits. Latches can be categorized based on how the input data D is sampled and stored based on the state of the enable signal. There are two categories, positive level sensitive latches and negative level sensitive latches. Let's discuss them in detail. Positive level sensitive latches. In a positive level sensitive latch, the input is sampled only when the enable signal is high or EN is equal to 1. When the enable signal is low, the input D is not sampled and the output remains unchanged. Here are the waveforms of the input and output of a positive level sensitive latch. As seen in these waveforms, when enable signal is 1, the output Q follows D. When enable is 0, the output holds its previous value. Negative level sensitive latch. In a negative level sensitive latch, the input is sampled only when the enable is low or EN equals to 0. When enable signal is high, the input D is ignored and the output remains unchanged. These are the timing waveforms of a negative level sensitive latch. When enable signal is 0, output Q follows the input D. When enable goes to 1, output Q holds its previous value. Now let's examine the timing arcs supported in a latch. Timing arcs represent the delay between specific pins, such as from an input to output or between two input pins. In latches, there are two types of timing arcs. Sequential arcs and setup and hold arcs. Sequential arcs are from data input D to output Q and enable input EN to output Q. Setup and hold arcs are between enable EN and data input D. Let's understand these arcs in detail. First, the sequential arcs from data input D to output Q. Here we assume that we are discussing a positive level sensitive latch. For this latch, when enable is high, output Q follows data input D. As seen in the waves, whenever D changes, Q changes as well. This relationship gives the timing arcs D rise, Q rise, and D fall, Q fall. Now let's look at the other sequential arc that exists between enable and output pin Q. To find this, let's consider this scenario. Initially, output Q is 0 and data input is 1. But since enable is 0, Q remains at 0. When enable transitions to 1, the output Q starts following the data input D and transitions to 1. This creates the timing arc EN rise, Q rise. In another scenario, suppose output Q is initially 1, as shown here, the data input D is 0 and EN toggles from 0 to 1. In this case, output Q transitions from high to low, creating the timing arc EN rise, Q fall. This was about sequential timing arcs. Now let's discuss setup and hold arcs. Here we assume we have a positive level sensitive latch. Setup and hold arcs exist in the latch between enable and data input D. If input data changes very close to the moment when enable signal transitions to low, the change in D may not be correctly reflected in output Q, or the latch might enter into a metastable state. To ensure the value of D is properly propagated to Q, there are certain timing constraints that enable EN and data input D must satisfy. First, the setup time constraint. Setup time is the minimum amount of time the data input D must be stable before the enable signal EN transitions to low or it gets deasserted. If this condition is violated, the data may not propagate correctly to output Q. The setup time requirement is shown here in the waveform. The data input D must be stable at least for the T setup time before the enable signal is deasserted. For the hold time constraint, hold time is the minimum amount of time the data input D must be stable after the enable signal EN transitions to low or it gets deasserted. Violating the hold time constraint can lead to incorrect data being latched or instability in the circuit. In these waveforms, T hold is the hold time, and the data must be stable at least for this much time after the enable signal is deasserted. Now let's understand why setup time is required in a latch circuit through a schematic diagram. Here is a positive level sensitive latch circuit designed using transmission gates and inverters. Here we have used clock signal as enable input because in most sequential circuits, the clock signal typically functions as enable input for latch. For the input data D to propagate correctly at output Q, D must remain stable for certain duration before the input transmission gate closes or clock signal goes low. The goal is to ensure that the value of D propagates to internal node N and stabilizes before TG1 closes, so that once the clock signal transitions to low and TG2 opens, the stable value at N can be reliably stored or latched in the memory loop. This stability requirements defines the setup time, which is the minimum duration D must be stable before clock signal is deasserted. Thus, in this circuit, we can define setup time as the delay of transmission gate TG1 plus the delay of inverters INV1 and INV2. This is the time required for input signal D to traverse through the transmission gate and both the inverters and stabilize at node N. Now let's discuss why we need hold time in a latch. If the input data D changes too quickly after the clock signal goes low, the transmission gate TG1 is not yet fully turned off and the new value of D might pass through TG1. This could corrupt or disturb the value that is stabilized at point N. Therefore, the data input D must be stable for certain duration after the clock transitions low until TG1 is fully turned off. For this circuit, the required hold time is determined by the delay for the I clock signal to reach zero in clock path minus the delay of transmission gate TG1. So the hold time of the circuit is two times of delay of inverter INV minus delay of TG1. So this brings us to the end of this video. Hope this discussion helps you to understand latch functionality and setup and hold constraints in latch circuits.